Hello students, now we will be doing clauses. What are clauses? A complex sentence will have two parts or more than two parts, but there is always a main clause and the other is dependent clause. The other is subordinate. Subordinate is something less which is dependent on the main clause. So, complex sentence, you break it into two parts. The first part is the main clause and the other is the subordinate or dependent clause. That's very simple to break the sentence and find out the clauses. Now, you have to find out what type it is, what type of clause it is. Whether it's a noun clause or adjective clause or it is an adverb clause. Now, the trick is you should know what answer the clause is giving. If it gives the answer to what, then it is noun clause. Whenever it is giving the answer to which and whom, it is adjective clause. And the adverb clause will have many types of subordinate and it gives different types like manner, place, time. We'll see that. Now, let us start with the noun clause. Now, whenever the answer is of what, it is noun clause. Now, see this example. Rahul fears. Rahul fears that he will fail. So, now Rahul is the subject, fear is the verb, and this clause is the object. So, now this is the verb. This is the verb. And when you ask a question, what Rahul fears that he will fail? You get the answer. You make a question of this main clause and you get the answer of what? What Rahul fears that he will fail. So you get that answer. It is a noun clause. Now, after knowing that it is a noun clause, it is telling about the fear. It is telling about the fear. That's the verb. So it is object of the verb. It is on that side. It is object, subject, verb, object. So, it is object of the verb fear in the main clause. It's the object of the fear main in the fear in the main clause. So, second one, object of the verb. Rahul fears that he will fail. So you have to write Rahul fears main clause. That he will fail is the subordinate noun clause, object of the verb fear in the main clause. So this is object of the verb. Now same sentence I write, what Rahul fears is his failure. So this part, the clause has come at the start, has become the subject. Now, when the clause has become a subject, you say, this is it. Now, this it is hidden. It is his failure. So, it is, in bracket you can write, is his failure, is the main clause. What Rahul fears is the subordinating noun clause, subject of the verb. Now, which verb it is? Is the supporting verb. Is the verb here. So, it is the supporting verb. So, subject of the verb is in the main clause. So, main clauses, it is his failure is main clause. What Rahul fears is the subordinating noun clause. Subject of the verb, which verb? Auxiliary verb, supporting verb. Which is this verb which is supporting? Is in the main clause. So, subject of the verb is in the main clause. Why? Because the clause has become a subject. Here it is an object. So object of the verb fears in the main clause. Here it is subject of the verb is in the main clause. I hope subject and object is very clear now. There should not be any confusion. When the main clause come at the start, it is object of the verb. When subordinating clause comes at the start, then it is subject of the verb. Now, complement of the verb. Complement of the verb. Rahul is that boy with intelligence. Rahul is. Now, this is again a verb. It is an auxiliary verb. It is verb of incomplete predication. Predicate has not been completed. Clause has started. So, here it complements the verb is. This clause complements the verb is. So, this is a noun clause that is complementing. This clause is the subordinate noun. This is main clause. Rahul is main clause. That boy with intelligence is subordinating noun clause. Subordinating noun clause. But what type of noun clause it is? It is the complement of the verb is in the main clause. It complements. This is the verb of incomplete predication. Predicate is not completed. So, it complements the verb is in the main clause. I hope you have understood. If you understand, it's very simple. Complement of the verb. Now, object of the preposition. Now, same sentence. Rahul is with. I put that preposition. Rahul is with, comma. With is a preposition. So, Rahul is with, comma, that boy with intelligence. Now, with is the preposition. It stops at with, comma, and the clause starts. Then it becomes object of the preposition with in the main clause. Rahul is with, that boy with intelligence. With is the preposition. So, it is object of the preposition with in the main clause. So this subordinating now is a noun clause and it's the object. This becomes the object of the preposition with in the main clause. Try to remember when verb ends, clause starts, then it is complement of the verb. When the preposition ends and the clause starts, then it is object of the preposition. It's ending, you see, and the clause starts. So, this is how you can find this complement of the verb and object of the preposition. Now, apposition to the noun. Apposition means two nouns which cannot be separated. They cling to each other, like Dr. APJ Kalam, the great scientist, Virat Kohli, the great cricketer. These two nouns cannot separate. Virat Kohli, the cricketer, is my brother, whatever. So, this Virat Kohli, the cricketer, is the subordinate clause. Virat Kohli is my brother is the main clause. The cricketer, the great cricketer, is the subordinating noun clause. So, what type of noun clause is it? It is in opposition to the noun Virat in the main clause. So, these two nouns, they are in opposition. They cannot be separated. Like Virat is a noun, cricketer is a noun. So, these two nouns, they cannot be separated. So, they are in opposition to each other. Dr. APJ Kalam, the great scientist, cannot be separated. They are in opposition to each other. So, Dr. Kalam, the great scientist, has died. So, Dr. APJ Kalam Azad has died. That's the main clause. Now, great scientist, that's the subordinating noun clause in opposition to the noun Dr. APJ Kalam. So, these two nouns, they cannot be separated. They are in opposition to each other. They are very much together. So, this is what noun clause is. It might sometimes seem difficult, but with practice, it will become very easy. And the steps you have to remember. Like, after the main verb, the clause starts, then it is object of the verb. But whenever the clause is at the start, then it is subject of the verb. When the verb, auxiliary verb, finishes, it does not complete but it finishes, and the clause starts, then it is complement of the verb is in the main clause. Whatever verb is, was, whatever. Now, whenever it is with the preposition with, to, whatever, then it is object of the preposition. And apposition is when two nouns, they are clinging to each other very much, then it is in apposition. So, now if you remember this, it is easy for you to understand and identify very easily. Now, as you know, adjective means it describes noun. Adjective, it describes noun. So, it has to tell something about the noun. Adjective has to tell something about noun. Now, whenever it answers a question, which and who, then it is adjective clause. Now, Rahul is the boy who studies well. Who studies well? Rahul is the boy who studies well. Now, who, the subordinator, who is present, and then therefore it is adjective clause. It's telling about the noun Rahul. So, adjective means it describes a noun. It describing Rahul. Therefore, it is adjective clause. Mumbai is a place which everyone likes to live. So, here which subordinator which is there, and therefore it is a adjective clause. Now, relative pronoun who, whom, which, present, it's an adjective clause. Relative adverbs, that, were, when, why, if it is present, then it can be adjective or it can be adverb clause. So, if these words are present, you have to check whether it's answering the question of which and who. So, Mumbai is the city that everyone loves. Which city everyone loves? Mumbai. You should get the answer for which and who. Then it is a adjective clause. Otherwise, you put in the adverb clause. Now, adverb clause is very simple because whenever the words connected to these things are seen, you identify the adverb clause. So, here place, word. If word is present in the sentence, then it's adverb clause of place. It is the city where he lives. So, it is adverb clause of place. He came in when the teacher arrived. When shows the time. And there are other words also which shows time, like till, until, before, after, as soon as, all these words, they show time. So, he entered as soon as the teacher came, then it is time. Condition. If you study, you will pass only if you study. That's the condition. If word is used, then it is condition. Purpose. He studies so that he passes. So that shows the purpose. Manner. He is as good as any other child in the class. As shows the manner. He reason. He studied because he wanted to pass. So that shows the Stephen. Comparison. He's taller than all the other boys in the class. T-H-A-N, than is used. It's comparison. Adverb clause of comparison. Result. So that. He studied so that he could pass. That shows the result. Then, though, although, even though he studied, he did not pass. Even though he studied, he did not pass. That's concession. So that would be adverb clause of concession. So this is the broad outline of classification of clauses. Bye-bye.